What if you were injured and developed severe pain that wouldn't go away? Would your government let you take the kind of medication you need?
I never thought directly about suicide. But I did, at a couple of different points in that, think it would be better not to be alive.
One day in 2005, Scott Gardner was cycling to work along this path when a homeless man pushed him off his bike. Gardner's body slammed into this jagged part of the pavement.
That was viciously painful. I screamed in pain. I think I passed out a little bit.
This is the first time he's returned to the scene of the accident.
This is where my life changed. And now it's really hitting more, way more than it did then.
Gardner's injuries included a broken femur, a broken collarbone, 3 crushed ribs, a concussion, and a collapsed lung.
There's a lot of things I just can't do.
After 8 surgeries and countless hours of physical therapy, Gardner's once active life is now filled with limitations.
I can't walk very far. I'll never run again.
He suffers from chronic pain that prevents him from sleeping more than a few hours at a time. And yet his pain today is nothing compared to the agonizing days and months following his accident.
When there's nothing but pain, there's no reason to live. There were times where the only way I could stay sane and civil was because I could take painkillers. I could take the Vicodin when I needed it.
But what about people who get injured today? If there was anything fortunate about Gardner's accident, it was that it happened long before this recent news.
Well, now a Food and Drug Administration panel is sounding the alarms.
This panel is now recommending that combination prescription drugs that include acetaminophen, like Percocet and Vicodin, be pulled from the market.
Some of the most effective prescription medications contain acetaminophen, a popular painkiller also found in many over-the-counter drugs. The FDA panel says it's better to ban drugs like Vicodin and Percocet than risk the liver damage that is caused by ingesting too much acetaminophen. It's a new twist on an old fear, prescription drug abuse.
Are you or someone you know addicted to prescription pills?
We hear about famous people who end up addicted to painkillers they once used for legitimate medical conditions.
I took the pain pills from a car accident.
For a leg injury.
And PSAs suggest that regular people get addicted all the time.
And then I tried to stop, but it was just way too addictive.
Blood all over me from shooting up.
And so you might be shocked to hear Gardner say this.
I didn't become addicted, and it was very easy to go off of them as long as I could, you know, do it in a controlled manner.
Surely he must be the exception that proves the rule.
The fear that people will become addicted in large numbers for medical treatment is just hype. It's propaganda.
Dr. Frank Fisher is a Harvard-trained physician. He says these people are the exceptions.
When patients take controlled substances, particularly opioid analgesics, for chronic pain, the addiction rate is incredibly low.
In 2008, the official Journal of the American Academy of Pain Medicine published a review of studies on the topic. What did the review find? Among patients who were prescribed pain medication and had no prior history of drug abuse, the abuse or addiction rate was less than 1/5 of 1%.
It's a nation of zombies.
But that's not the story we hear on TV.
Woke up 3 days later, covered in my own feces.
We're in a blind panic about these supposed threats. And they're very small compared to most other things that actually threaten our society.
The FDA panel says 458 people die each year from acetaminophen overdoses, and that justifies banning medication like Vicodin and Percocet. But nearly 700 people die from drowning in swimming pools each year, and more than 1,800 die falling down stairs. Should we ban pools and stairs?
All medications are dangerous. We got to remember that.
Yes, but shouldn't we also remember that pain patients need these medications?
I took Vicodin for a couple of years. I don't feel bad that I did it. I needed it. It got me through a very tough period in my life.
And this committee said, yank them off the market. No more Vicodin, no more Percocet.
What if the government does end up banning many prescription painkillers?
To me, that's intensely cruel. I don't think people who haven't dealt with pain really know what it's like.
Remember, we're all just one accident away from having to deal with severe chronic pain. So if that day ever comes, here's hoping you get the treatment you need. For Reason TV, I'm Ted Ballacher. That's what you are.